60% of women giving birth at hospitals use epidural anesthesia. Epidural anesthesia blocks nerve impulses from a particular region of the body. It provides analgesia rather than anesthesia, meaning that while you feel no pain, you are still entirely aware. The procedure is as follows. You will be asked to arch your back and remain still while lying on your side. An antiseptic solution will be applied and a local anesthetic will be injected. Then, a long needle is injected until it reaches the space just outside the membrane that surrounds the spinal nerves. This is called the epidural space. Afterward, a small tube or catheter is threaded through the needle into this epidural space. Then the needle is carefully removed, leaving the catheter in place to provide continuous medication for the rest of your labor. Many women describe an immediate feeling of warmth and tingling in the feet, which extends up their legs and torso as the spinal anesthetic takes effect. It will take about 20 minutes for your pain relief to take full effect. It is normal to feel numb from the lower chest down to the feet. Epidurals are very safe. However, as with all medications and medical procedures, there are potential side effects. The medication may lower your blood pressure, which may also slow your baby's heart rate. To make this less likely, you will be given extra fluids through a tube in your arm. Some epidural anesthesia may lead to a headache as well. Although epidural anesthetic is injected just outside the membrane that surrounds the spinal cord, a headache is possible if the membrane is unintentionally punctured. This causes cerebrospinal fluid leakage, leading to a headache. It is usually a severe headache starting 24 hours after the procedure, which gets better when lying down and worse on standing or sitting. Many people are worried that an epidural could paralyze them. Rest assured, cases of permanent nerve damage are extremely rare, and if nerve damage occurs, it is likely associated with prolonged pushing and positioning during the pushing process, rather than the epidural itself. Keep in mind that most nerve damage will heal on its own within a few months and won't cause permanent damage. Thank you for watching this video. Please watch my other videos if you would like to know what to expect during a vaginal delivery or C-section.